Newly released data from the FBI shows Jewish people and Jewish institutions in the United States were the overwhelming target of religious-based hate crimes in the country last year. The agency's 2018 Hate Crime Statistics Report finds hate crimes motivated by religious bias accounted for more than 1,500 offenses. The majority of those offenses, almost 58%, were directed against Jewish people. Jews make up about 2% of the U.S. population. Melissa Braunstein, senior contributor for The Federalist, joins me now with her analysis. Melissa, welcome back to the program.
Good to be here.
What's your reaction, first off, when you hear about these disturbing figures?
I think the unfortunate news is that it's not new. This has been the case for the last several years, that Jews in America have held the dubious distinction of leading in hate crimes against religious communities. It's something that's been trending upward as an issue, and I'm glad that your show is paying attention to it.
You wrote a piece describing what you call the new normal for Jewish people in our nation's synagogues and throughout our society. What have you been witnessing personally over the terms of these additional, over these years, and how much have you seen in terms of additional security?
Security has definitely increased. I think there's been a huge change since I was a kid. The world that my children are growing up in is very different. You could just walk into synagogues when I was growing up. There was no security, and now, if you go to religious schools, you go to synagogues, you go to Jewish community centers, it's very common to see all sorts of security settings, to have key fobs, to have video systems set up, to have security guards, to have police officers. It's very rare now in a major city to go to a Jewish institution where there's not extra security. It's become normal.
And of course, churches are following the same trend. We all remember a little over a year ago when a mass shooting at the Tree of Life Synagogue in Pittsburgh left 11 people dead, 6 more injured. The shooter reportedly had a history of posting anti-Semitic sentiments on social media. What role do you think the anti-Jewish rhetoric plays in fueling these kinds of incidents?
I think the rhetoric is a problem. I think people say this all the time, but it's very true that when you have sort of very fiery language, it very quickly can lead, in certain cases, to action. And Tree of Life is a great example of deadly action. It's something that I think, as much as possible, you want to preemptively stop before it starts, and which is not to say knocking out the First Amendment, but just to encourage people to be very careful of the language that they're using.
Just last month, the American Jewish Committee released its survey of Jewish people in the U.S. The responses indicate American Jews view anti-Semitism as a significant problem in America and one that is getting worse, just like you said. What do you think is needed to bring about change?
I would love to see more people, starting with your viewers, saying that anti-Semitism is not just a Jewish problem, that it's everybody's problem, that it's something that affects our democracy and our society. History has shown that what starts with the Jews typically does not end with us. This is a problem for our society everywhere. I would love to see more people speaking up to our elected officials and demanding that they take action and pay attention to this, that this is not a problem that just gets ignored.
Very important message. Melissa Braunstein, senior contributor for The Federalist, thank you so much for coming on talking with us.
Thank you.